Hi friends, I am Balaji Rao. Welcome to BR Max class. In this class, we will learn how to calculate this integral. If given integral is any one of these three integrals, then the procedure is same. First, we will try to identify this integral is any one of these three integrals or not. Little bit of simplification I'll do here so that we can easily compare whether it is any one of the given three forms or not. Integral of 1 divided by square root of, in the denominator you multiply this x minus 1 into x minus 2. You see here x into x is x square, x into 2 is minus 2x, minus 1 into x is minus x, minus 2x minus x is minus 3x. Okay, minus of minus plus 1 into 2 is 2. If you observe this integral, this is integral of 1 divided by square root of x square minus 3x plus 2 dx. This integral is in which form? You can observe in the denominator square root is there. So this integral is of this form. This integral is of the form integral of 1 divided by square root of ax square plus bx plus c dx. If the given integral is any one of these three integrals, the procedure is same. What is that procedure? We will consider the expression ax square plus bx plus c. You observe here, we consider x square minus 3x plus 2. After considering this expression, we will make sure that x square coefficient is 1 or not. If x square coefficient is not 1, we will make it 1 by taking that number common. If you observe this expression, here what is x square coefficient? X square coefficient is 1 only. So nothing to worry. Okay, so now my main intention is I want to write this whole expression in any one of these forms. A square plus x square or x square minus a square or a square minus x square. I just want to write this full expression in any one of these forms. So we'll follow a trick to write these things in any one of these forms. You observe here x square minus 3x. First, I am going to write x square minus 3x like this. You please listen this carefully. Here few things are fixed. As x square is there, x square coefficient is 1. Here x is fixed. Always we will write x here only, right? After x square, what sign is there here? Minus sign is there. So here we will write minus. After x square, if plus sign is there, we will write plus here. Okay? And you close the bracket and you write the square here. These things are fixed. Now, we need to write some number here. To write that number, you always keep 2x in your mind. Now, 2x into some number you need to write. 2x into this number must give 3x. Only 3x. It's not about minus 3x. You should get 3x. What is that number? If I write here 3 by 2, here 2 will get cancelled. I'll get 3x. Try to understand. So, we identified what number to write here. What is that number? That number is 3 by 2. After writing this, minus, irrespective of whatever the sign is here. Here minus is fixed. Here x is fixed, here square is fixed, here minus is fixed. Minus square of this number, 3 by 2 whole square. What is 3 by 2 whole square? 3 by 2 whole square is 9 by 4. What happened here? Whatever the expression I written here, you observe this. If I simplify this, I'll get x square minus 3x. If you want, you can check here. You observe here, the same thing I written here, I'll expand this, what you will get x square, a square plus b square minus 2ab minus 9 by 4. You can check that this plus 9 by 4 minus 9 by 4 will get cancelled, this 2 will get cancelled, you will get x square minus 3x. So here, in place of x square minus 3x, I can write this expression. This is the procedure. This is the sixth problem we are doing. I think by this time you must know what we are doing. Okay. And what is the remaining here? X square minus 3x. We can write like this. What is remaining here? Plus 2 is remaining. That plus 2 I'll write here. Okay. If we simplify this further, you will get like this. X minus 3 by 2 whole square minus 9 by 4 plus 2. Minus 9 by 4 plus 2. What is LCM? LCM is 4. What you will get here? Minus 9. Plus 8. Minus 9 plus 8 is minus 1. Minus 1 divided by 4. Okay. So here minus 9 by 4 plus 2 is what? Minus 1 by 4. This is minus 1 by 4. My main intention is I want to write this full expression in any one of these forms. It is coming like in the form of x square minus a square. Here I can write one more step. What is that? this equal to x minus 3 by 2 whole square minus 1 by 4 can be written as 1 by 2 whole square, right? Finally, we can write this x square minus 3x plus 2 can be written as x minus 3 by 2 whole square minus 1 by 2 whole square. Now, in this integral, in place of x square minus 3x plus 2, you can write this expression, okay? So, I'll write the same thing. You observe this equal to integral of 1 divided by square root of, see, in place of x square minus 3x plus 2, now you can write this expression, write it x minus 3 by 2 whole square minus 1 by 2 whole square dx. Okay, now we need to integrate this. To integrate this, we learn 6 properties in previous classes. If you want to learn those properties, you watch class number 70. Integral of 1 divided by root over x square minus a square dx. What is the formula for this? The formula is log mod x plus root over x square minus a square plus c. Okay. Now the point is we need to integrate this. This integral is of this form. Actually, this integration we do by substitution method. But it creates unnecessary confusion here if I do this problem by substitution method. The point is you can write this answer directly by using this formula. See, this integral is of the same form. This integral of 1 divided by root over x square minus a square. Only the difference is here x square is there. Here in place of x, x minus 3 by 2 is there. So what I'll do, how to write its answer directly? Just simply you write this formula. Okay, in this formula, wherever x is there, there you write x minus 3 by 2. Wherever a is there, there you write 1 by 2. Okay, so I'm just applying this formula. This equal to, just apply the formula. What you will get? Log mod x. Wherever x you see, there you write x minus 3 by 2. X minus 3 by 2 plus root over x. X square. Wherever x is there you write x minus 3 by 2. X square, x minus 3 by 2 whole square minus a square. Wherever a is there you write 1 by 2. 1 by 2 whole square plus c. So here I can write one more simplification step. That equal to log mod x minus 3 by 2 plus square root of, you see this x minus 3 by 2 whole square minus 1 by 2 whole square. You observe here x minus 3 by 2 whole square minus 1 by 2 whole square. This can be written as x square minus 3x plus 2. So here I'll write x square minus 3x plus 2 plus c. That's it. Little bit of practice is needed. If you practice 4 to 5 problems continuously, definitely you will feel that these problems are very easy.